Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 77 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 131 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 132 and 133 and 134. Question 132. You have an Azure subscription. You create the Azure storage account shown in following exhibit. As per this exhibit, we have created a storage account under the subscription 1, under the resource group 1, and this is the name of storage account. The important thing to note for this storage account is the replication, which we have used LRS. Another important thing to note for this storage account is the access tier, which is the hot access tier. We do have cool and archive as well. That's it. Let's scroll down. Answer area. Question 1 in answer area is that minimum number of copies of the storage account will be. So we are looking for what would be the minimum number of copies for LRS type storage account, which have the redundancy type LRS. That we know that it is 3, as shown in the figure as well. Therefore 3 is the correct answer. Next question is to reduce the cost of infrequently accessed data in the storage account, you must modify which setting. So as we know that access tier should be modified. Right now we are using hot, we can use the cool to reduce the cost of infrequently accessed data. Therefore the access tier is the correct answer. Let's move to next question. Question 133. You have an Azure storage account named Storage 1. You plan to use AzCopy to copy data to Storage 1. You need to identify the storage services in the Storage 1 to which you can copy the data. Which storage service should you identify? As we know that AzCopy is a command line utility that we can use to copy blobs or files to or from a storage account. Therefore option B is the correct answer. Let's move to next question. Question 134. You have an Azure storage account named Storage 1 that uses Azure Blob storage and Azure file storage. You need to use AzCopy to copy data to Blob storage and file storage in Storage 1. Which authentication method should you use for each type of storage? So first we need to check for blob storage which one we can use, and for the file storage which one we can use. So let's go to Microsoft documentation portal and check it. We are in Microsoft documentation portal and on the get started with AzCopy page. So here AzCopy is defined like AzCopy is command line utility that we can use to copy blobs or files to or from the storage account. Authorize AzCopy. We can provide authorization credentials by using Active Directory or by using Shared Access Signature Token. Therefore, for blob storage, we can use Azure Active Directory and Shared Access Signature Token. For the blob storage with hierarchical namespace, we can use Azure Active Directory as well as shared access signature token. For file storage, shared access signature only supported. Back to the question. Therefore, for blob storage, we can use Azure Active Directory and shared access signature only. So this one is correct answer. For the file storage, we can use only shared access signature token. Therefore, this statement would be correct, that shared access signature only. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.